மாஸ் கீழ பாவூர்.
ஹாய், வெல்கம் டு மாஸ் கீழப்பாவூர் சேனல். ஐ எம் டாக்டர் அருணா சண்முகவேல். இன் திஸ் வீடியோ வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் த நியூக்ளியஸ், கோர்ஸ், பிரான்ச்சஸ் அண்ட் ஏரியா ஆஃப் சப்ளை ஆஃப் ஹைப்போகிளாசல் நர்வ். பிஃபோர் ஸ்டார்டிங் திஸ் செஷன், லெட் அஸ் சீ அ கோட். டோன்ட் ஸ்டாப் டில் யூ ரீச் த டாப். Shall we move on to the topic? The hypoglossal nerve is the 12th cranial nerve. Since it enters the tongue from below, it is named as hypoglossal. Its functional component is that it carries somatic efferent fibers to all the muscles of tongue except palatoglossus. The general somatic afferent column is the mesencephalic nucleus of trigeminal nerve, where proprioceptive fibers from tongue end. The nucleus for hypoglossal nerve is located in the hypoglossal triangle in the floor of fourth ventricle. It is 2 cm long. It is divided into two parts, one for genioglossus muscle and another for rest of the muscles. The part for genioglossus receives only contralateral corticonuclear fibers. The part for rest of the muscles receives both ipsilateral and contralateral corticonuclear fibers. Shall we see the course of the nerve? The three parts of its course are intramedullary course, intracranial course and extracranial course. In the intramedullary course, the fibers of hypoglossal nerve run forwards, lateral to medial longitudinal bundle, medial lemniscus and pyramidal tract, and medial to the reticular formation and olivary nucleus. The nerve emerges as 10 to 15 rootlets from the anterolateral sulcus of the medulla between pyramid and olive. In the intracranial part, the hypoglossal rootlets unite to form two roots. These two roots lie posterior to the vertebral artery. They run laterally to enter into the anterior condylar canal or hypoglossal canal. The two rootlets join together to form a single trunk within the canal. Then it comes out of the hypoglossal canal. Where is this canal? It lies medial and posterior to the jugular foramen. In its extracranial course, after coming out of the hypoglossal canal, the hypoglossal nerve lies deep to internal carotid artery, internal jugular vein, 9th, 10th and 11th cranial nerves. The nerve runs forwards and laterally. It makes half circle around the inferior ganglion of vagus nerve. It crosses the vagus and runs between the internal carotid artery and internal jugular vein. Just before the nerve turns forwards near the angle of mandible, it lies deep to the posterior belly of digastric muscle. The nerve crosses the following arteries in order: inferior sternocleidomastoid branch of occipital artery, internal carotid artery, external carotid artery, loop of lingual artery. Then the nerve enters the digastric triangle deep to the posterior belly of digastric muscle. Remember, hypoglossal nerve is related deep to posterior belly of digastric twice. The nerve then runs superficial to hyoglossus muscle and then superficial to genioglossus muscle. It enters into the tongue from below and gives branches to all the muscles of tongue except palatoglossus. Have you heard of Lesser's triangle? It is a triangle present within the submandibular triangle. It was named after a German surgeon named Ladislas Leon Lesser. The inferior boundary of Lesser's triangle is formed by anterior belly of digastric and intermediate tendon of digastric. The superior boundary is formed by hypoglossal nerve. The posterior boundary is formed by posterior margin of mylohyoid muscle. Floor of this triangle is formed by hyoglossus and mylohyoid muscle. The lingual artery is present deep to the hyoglossus muscle in the Lesser's triangle. Shall we move on to the branches of hypoglossal nerve? The branches may be divided into branches of the nerve proper and branches that represent fibers which reach it from the first cervical nerve. The nerve proper supplies all the intrinsic muscles of tongue, that is superior longitudinal, inferior longitudinal, transverse and vertical muscles. It also supplies all the extrinsic muscles of tongue except palatoglossus. The muscles supplied by hypoglossal are genioglossus, hyoglossus and styloglossus. The palatoglossus is supplied by cranial accessory nerve through pharyngeal plexus through vagus nerve. The ventral ramus of first cervical nerve hitchhikes hypoglossal nerve. These fibers forms descendants hypoglossi, which supplies geniohyoid and thyrohyoid muscles. The descendant cervicalis is formed by ventral rami of C2 and C3. Both descendants hypoglossi and descendant cervicalis join together in front of the internal jugular vein to form ansa cervicalis. The muscles supplied by ansa cervicalis are superior belly of omohyoid, sternohyoid, sternothyroid and inferior belly of omohyoid. When the hypoglossal nerve passes through its canal, it gives meningeal branch that supplies dura mater of the posterior cranial fossa. This meningeal fibers are also derived from ventral ramus of first cervical nerve. In the next video, we'll discuss about the communication and clinical anatomy of hypoglossal nerve. Shall we end up this session with a quote? It's not enough to be busy, so are the ants. The question is, what are we busy about? Thank you for watching.
If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon to get instant notifications.